Good morning to all my dear students. In our last science class, we discussed about aquatic plants, right? Today we are going to learn about terrestrial plants. So, refresh your memory, students. Aquatic plants, we already know that plants which grow in water are called aquatic plants. Then what about terrestrial? Just opposite, that is xerophytes. Plants which grow on land are called terrestrial plants, right? We already discussed that one. Now we can check about the types of terrestrial plants. Based on the adaptation, we can classify terrestrial plants into different types. Some plants, they can live on hills. Some plants we can see in plains. Some plants we can see in hot and cold region. Then in marshy areas. And some plants like cactus we can see in desert areas. Oh, someone is asking something. Can you say loudly?
Can you tell me about this one by one? And how are they differ from each other?
Don't worry, my dears. I will help you. We can go to our classroom, okay?
Dear children, you can check the human cases. We are living in different regions. Some are living in mountains. Some are living in plain. Some are living in like marshy region or desert region, like that, is it, children? It is based on the climatic region. We are wearing the different type of the cloth also, is it? So based on the special features, we also changing our dresses, our lifestyle, like that. Plants also changing their special features. So we can check based on the adaptation. Some plants are living plains. You can check this picture. Some plants are living plains. Some plants are living hilly region. Some plants are living in windy region, like in grassland. Some plants are living in desert region. And some plants that are living in marshy region, like means wet, the soil is very wet, soft soil, full of water. That is marshy region. So we can check what are the different adaptation they are following one by one. First, plants living in plain region. Plain, mainly in plain region, very dry climate is there. But the thing is that sometimes little rainfall and hot weather, but sometimes little rainfall, sometimes very high rainfall. In little rainfall, they are shedding their leaves, okay, in autumn season. That we call deciduous plant, deciduous. Then, the example for deciduous plant is, we can say, banyan tree. But next season in plains, that is, it's fully rainfall. Fully rainfall, but hot climate, fully rainfall. That is, plants every time fully green leaves throughout the year. Okay, that we called evergreen plant. That plants we call evergreen plants. So, these two types of plants mainly seen in plain tree region. Okay, plants which are living in the plains, deciduous plant, we can see deciduous plant and evergreen plant. Okay. In evergreen plant, we can say example coconut, like that. Okay. The next we can check plants living in a hilly region. In hilly region, it is a conical shaped plant. Its branches is like a conical shape. We also call it a coniferous plant. And what about its leaf? Its leaves is a very narrow leaves. Why it is a narrow leaves, children? Because full of snow in hilly region. So, actually, if it is broad leaves, what will happen? They collect the snow and plants will die, right? So, if it is narrow leaves, the snow is easily slide off, right? That's why leaves are very narrow and dry. And its branches also cone shape. Okay, so it is a coniferous plant. And what about its flower, children? Its flower is like a cone shape. Okay, inside of this cone, there is a seed present. So, flower is also like a cone shape. We can say example, pine tree or fir, like that. Okay, then next is in windy region, mainly in the grassland. We can see the plants in windy region like a umbrella shaped plants. Like a umbrella shaped plants. Because of why? Because otherwise it is bent down because of wind. So, to prevent the wind, its branches are like an umbrella shaped plant. Okay. So, main adaptation is it's an umbrella shaped plant. Okay. Then, What about desert plants living in a desert region? It is like, for example, we can take cactus plant or aloe vera. Aloe vera we can check. Okay, stem is very broad and fleshy stem, is it? Maximum they are storing the water in stem. They store maximum amount of water. Okay, and what about leaf? Its leaves are, its leaves modified as like a spine to reduce the loss of water. For reducing the loss of water, it is modified as like a spine. Okay, then, and it store maximum amount of water where? Maximum amount of water it store in its stem, fleshy stem. It has fleshy stem. Okay, children, fleshy stem to store the water. And leaves are modified as a spines. And what about its roots, children? Its roots are actually, its roots are deeply go inside the water, to inside the soil to collect the water. It leaves deeply go inside the soil to collect the water. These are the special features of desert plant. Next, we are going to check about the plants which are living in marshy region. In marshy region, actually soil is very wet, soft soil. We can see the plants of root is above the soil. It is very different. Plants of the root is above the soil. This root we call breathing root. This root we call breathing root. Okay. It takes the gases from the air. That is, its root is breathing root. Okay. And this plant is fully above the water. We can say, we can also call this plant mangrove plant. Okay. Mangrove plant. Example is mangrove plant. Okay, children. So these all are the different features seen in terrestrial plant. Okay, so all should have learned nicely different adaptations of plant. Thank you, children.